Hey, it's Pastor Chris, and I want to take a few minutes to talk to you about something. I hope I don't go too long because I'm really passionate about this idea of compassion and conviction. If you're around me for any amount of time, you'll hear me talk about this. It is the title of the book that I wrote with my good friends Justin Gibney and Michael Ware. And if you haven't read that book, go get that book and read it. But it's more than just the title of the book. It is the idea that the book is about, which is the basic idea that you can have convictions. Strong beliefs that you care about that accord to how you see yourself and how you see the world. You can have convictions, you should have convictions, but with your convictions, you can also have compassion. You can have genuine concern for people who don't embrace those same convictions that you have. You can have concern for them. You can have respect and regard for people who do not see the world the way that you do. And let me tell you something, in this modern political discourse, this idea of compassion and conviction is a radical idea because this is a way that we can talk about, for instance, the sanctity of life of a child without disregarding, and I'm talking about the child in the womb, but you can talk about that without disregarding the quality of life of the mother, without disregarding the quality of life of that child when and if the child is born. You can have that conversation respectfully and come to something on that. Compassion, conviction is a way to talk about the fact that we need to change, make big changes in our policing and law enforcement system, but we don't have to pretend that there's no such thing as criminals. We don't have to pretend that there's no such thing as crime. For me, compassion and conviction has been for a long time a way to talk about the fact that we do need to completely reinvent our education system. But we can have that conversation without being disrespectful toward and disregarding the work that teachers do in this country every day and have done for a long time, even before there was a big, you know, education reform movement. This idea of compassion and conviction is really the only way that we can move past this stuck moment that we're at in our government. If you look, you can see that in the last year or so, we have failed to do anything nationally on police reform. We have failed to get anything done on LGBTQ rights. We have failed to do big things to reimagine this economy. And a $2,000 check is not it. We should be talking about guaranteed basic income. We should be strengthening labor unions and strengthening grassroots sort of community level economics. We haven't done any of that stuff. We haven't done anything that we need to do on the stuff that we need to do on education. We haven't gotten that stuff done. And it's not because you don't see that it needs to be done and I don't see that it needs to be done. It's not that people all over the country don't know it and want it to happen. It's that there are too many people in power who have become experts at keeping us hating each other, keeping us convinced that you can't work with people who see the world differently from you. You got to hate them. You got to be against them. You got to try to hurt them and destroy them. And that's why I'm glad that compassion and conviction is not just an idea and it's not just a book title. It really is a movement. There are leaders all over this country who are building organizations around this idea and really giving birth to a new way of doing politics and a new way of doing government. This campaign for Congress that I'm running, it is a part of that movement. And I'm really glad that tomorrow night I get to convene a table, a Zoom meeting of some of these national leaders who are building organizations, educating people and bringing forth a real grassroots movement of compassion and conviction. And if you have listened to me talk about this for four straight minutes, you might be a true believer. And so while this event tomorrow is a fundraiser for my congressional campaign, I want to invite you, if you watch this video to this point, like I asked you to in the blurb, I want to invite you to this event free of charge. No cover charge. Even if you can't give tomorrow, I want you to be there because we're not just raising money for the campaign. We're building this movement. Obviously, if you can give tomorrow, do that. But there is a link. I didn't identify the link because I wanted people to watch the video. There's a link right here in the video description that you can click and you can sign up. I will send you the access for the Zoom meeting tomorrow. Justin Gibney is going to be there. Michael Ware is going to be there. Amara Patel, who is the national candidate for the American Solidarity Party, is going to be there. Cory Porter is going to be there. A lot of great folks who are leading this movement around the country are going to be in the room, and I want you to be in the room. I'll be in the room, and I just want us to connect around this because this campaign is about this movement. This campaign is part of this movement. And so if you're a part of this movement, which I believe you are, if you're still watching at 5 minutes and 12 seconds, I want you to be there. So click that link. I'll send you the Zoom info tomorrow evening at 6 p.m. Central Time. We'll be in for about an hour or so, be able to talk about what's happening in our movement. You can ask questions of some of these really great leaders. And I hope to see you in the Zoom tomorrow. Thanks so much for watching the whole video. Bless you.